scrapping, to say the least, I think. But there's still been some great racing, and they've been fighting the elements. But a lot of the teams have put some fairly good, steady, fast teams times down over the weekend, despite the ground, and really showing some confidence in a few of these teams.
Yeah, so coming out now, we've got our teams in the orange. It is Amy Richards riding Indy, and that's the team of Top and Tails.
In the pink there, we have Just Wing It, and that's Annette on the horse.
Then in the dark green and gold stars, that's Emily Gray, and that is the team of Just Drag.
And there in the red, we have Send It Siblings.
And then at the back in the green, it is five-time national championship team, Dead Pigeons. So this is going to be an interesting heat. You know, we've shortened the course for the elite. There's no weave, and they were getting some serious fast pace. And Chill Winston, who aren't out here at the moment, but will see racing, really want to get a win. So ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a loud and noisy show, so we might as well start as the way we mean to go on. So please put your hands together for our teams of Horseboarding UK. This is not like other equestrian sports. We don't want you to be quiet. We don't want you to sit there and just think to yourselves. We want you to make as much noise as possible. And you're up against it because there's not that many of you around the arena today. So the more noise you make, the faster these teams will go. It gets the adrenaline pumping in the board riders, in the horse rider, and most importantly, inside the horse. And they just want to go faster and faster. So pick your favorite teams and give them some support.
Yeah, and some of these guys will really be feeling it by now over a long weekend of racing. All the bruises and bumps will be screaming, and they will have to fight through that for another round, and that's why we can't wait to see it, because the last one was quite hectic. Lots of spills, and I mean, it's been a challenge for every team, but I think the advanced teams have got a chance here to go up against the elite, Tom, as well, as they're doing the advanced course, and that must be quite fun for them.
Yeah, you've got teams like Just Drag and Send It Siblings. They're now running the exact same course as the elite because there's no weave. And they're able just to pit themselves and know how far off the pace they actually are, you know, in that bid, because they all want to go up into the elite class. So, this is our first elite team. It is Charlie Buss. She is an 8-time national champion. On the board is Aidan Beamish. He holds the world record for longest jump ever done by being towed by a horse. And the horse is a Ranji Boom, and the team is Dead Pigeons. So they start off as the way they mean to go on. They came fourth in the last round as they hit the first corner. 27 miles an hour. Wow. That is fast into this turn.
For their first run, ladies and gentlemen, they are going for it on this run. You can see that straight away, stretching out the horse there. Ranji Boom, the new element in this team, as they come across a diagonal. Aidan grabbing the handle with both arms, obviously really feeling it, but looking really, really good and smooth. Really got the groove on this one, Tom.
Yeah, they've just come out all cylinders firing. Aidan Beamish doing a lot of work as they go into the 90 degree. It's 33 seconds on the split. That is a fast split, especially from this morning. Now they've got one more corner as they go into John Bowles' bend. Ladies and gentlemen, get behind this team because you're going to see a hot lap as they're going to cross the finish line. It's Dead Pigeon. They're making their bid straight away for first place.
Wow.
With a time of 51.97 seconds. That's going to be hard to beat, Ross.
Well, not that I needed waking up, but that was a good start. They really sort of kicked into gear, and it was a bit unexpected, but they're obviously going for it straight away, and that's fair enough. They sort of know people are tired, getting their heads a bit, Tom, with a good time straight away. Lay it down.
That used to be my game.
That was your game, Tom.
Try and just mess with them a little bit, go, this is what I'm doing. So that's a good elite time, but now we go into our other class. It's our advanced class. These teams, not quite as fast because they're still learning, they're coming up the ranks, but this is a brother-sister team. You've got Fenella on the horse. She's only 15 years old. She's towing her brother, Josh, who's only just 18 years old. They are literally half the age of some of the other teams that are racing out there.
Yeah, and they look really good. They've been improving slowly ever since I've seen them a few comps back. And they start off steady and they get a feel of the ground. They get into it themselves. They're very, very mature riding, really, for their age.
You say steady, but I mean, for these guys, 19 miles an hour into turn one, that's a good pace from this team. And Josh has been complaining about his legs all weekend. As he gets low into that top corner, he's working hard. Fenella now got the point where she can let the pony out a little bit more, but just look at that. She doesn't. She keeps the control. She knows that this is how fast she can go for Josh. Round red back boots, double gate into the chicane.
Yeah, Josh takes a tight corner there, bit of a pull as a result through the chicane, but he's handled it.
He's on the wrong line there. Oh. Can he get back in? It's a big pull.
Oh, he's struggling. He's back inside, so that's good. And as they hit the split time at 44 seconds, so that's pretty good for them, especially on their first run, Tom.
Yeah, definitely, and a lot of proactive work from Josh. Now all they need to do is just not push too hard. Josh getting low on the back, and Fenella really has to make sure she doesn't put the gas on too soon as they get towards the finish line. Now here's where the gas can come on, but they don't. They keep it steady. This is perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, with a time of 67.34 seconds, it is Send It Siblings.
You can see how often the rider there is checking back on the border, and that's what it's all about, ladies and gentlemen. You've got to keep the border with you, and that's great teamwork. The brother and sister can sometimes work against you if you're sort of that close to your teammate, but it really works for them. They have great communication, and it's straight off the bat.
And Fennell is such an experienced horse rider. Like, I keep forgetting she's only 15. With the skill that comes with, you know, holding the horse back, looking after your brother, setting the pace, not getting finish line hungry, as I would call it, when you're just like, yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
And she just shows great composure for someone so young. So I think her horse supporting career is going to be amazing.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, there's so much potential in that team, as we were saying before, and can't wait to see them progress as the sport carries on. But here's another team, absolutely fabulous. A new team, Tom, and we've seen them race a little bit now. They've just been going around, just getting used to it. 15 miles per hour into the first corner. The ground's looking a lot better, Tom, than it has in the last previous runs. You think you're going to see the benefit? Already the teams have started quite quickly, the other ones.
Yeah, the ground really holding together for this, and this team, absolutely fabulous. They saw us here last year. They've got their equipment together. They came down on the Friday day before build, and then they've gone through their assessment, and here they are racing. And that's how you guys could get involved. You could literally contact us via the website, horseboardinguk.org, and then you could be on that side racing an event like this. But these guys starting to work well together. Board rider going a bit wide there and having to cut back in. But all in all, pony starts to drop into a bit of a trot. You know, they just need to say, look, this is the game, pony. This is what we're doing.
Yeah, going around the 90, looking quite smooth, obviously quite a slow pace, but it's all about them just learning and getting the communication right between all of them. The board is sort of, he has slightly bigger wheels on his board, doesn't he, Tom? And I think that's probably helped him a bit on the earlier days, but now it's drying up a bit, maybe it's a bit more difficult.
Yeah, those 9-inch wheels definitely do help on the ruts. But as they come towards the finish line, ladies and gentlemen, their first weekend competing, please put your hands together for the team of Absolutely Fabulous with a time of 89.58 seconds. But like to say, we do have a trade stand right next to the commentary box. After the show, if you feel like this is something you'd like to get involved in, come and have a chat with us. Or go to our website, horseboardinguk.org, or find us on Facebook, Instagram, or TikTok with the tag at horseboardinguk.
Okay, next in the arena, we have TNT in the orange there. Ryan Roberts waiting on his board in the corner of the arena. They have an important run now because they are one of the teams that tend to go out very quickly, straight away, because not too much gas in that tank for that horse, so they want to get it done on their foundation run.
This is a big course. Even though we've reduced it, it's a big course for Little Indy. Only 15-2, taking on the X racehorses. She's an X showing pony, and they've only really got one shot at this, and they're going to need every ounce of support. I can tell you that Ryan's legs will be killing him. His arms will be tired. Indy is coming to the end of the weekend, and they will only have one single shot at this. So if you want to find a team to get behind, I think these guys are going to be that one.
Yeah, and I mean, Little Indy's so good on the weave, it's a shame we can't see her do that, but still going to be quick. I think we're rearranging some of the gates at some point, or just checking that they're all in the right place before we start racing again. Yeah, it's going to be a tough one for TNT to maybe get a winning run. But hopefully they can get a competitive one that maybe knocks some of their other teams down, so their other team, Blues and Twos, can take advantage.
Yeah, they'll be looking. Yeah, I think they've definitely got pace from this morning. That, you know, they went out. I don't think they gave it everything they could. They just wanted to see what the ground was like. It's now started to dry up. It's going to be less heavy on the horses. It's going to be less heavy on the board rider. So this is where we see, you know, caveman Ryan Roberts come into a bit of...
One of the best around, Tom, isn't he? One of the best around Ryan Roberts here.
Current border champion.
Current border champion indeed, yeah, I did forget that. And
beat me by a single point, I'm not sour about it.
Just beat you, Tom, yeah.
But this is Amy Richards. It is Indy, is the 15-2 little showing pony, and the board rider is Ryan Roberts. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a hot lap, and they're going to look to try and take first place as these little legs become a blur and they set flying towards the speed trap as they hit corner one. It is 25 miles an hour. I'm pretty sure that was faster than that. Look at those little legs go as they hit Bruco Bend. Now Ryan's sitting right on the outside, but he keeps it intact.
Oh, this is all or nothing. They are having to go for this. This is all they've got. So Ryan's going to have to pull this out of the bag straight off. No warm-up for this team. Little Indy really rocking the chicane like it's not even there. Look at the pullout of there. That's really helping Ryan on this course as the split time
32
is.
Seconds on the split. They're a second up on the split from Dead Pigeons. This could be a first place run as they come into the last turn. It's 21 miles an hour. That's ridiculously fast. Ladies and gentlemen, get behind this team. Make all the noise that you can as they head through Bruco Bend onto the finish line with a time of 49.73 seconds. Ooh. They smash into first place and now have a lead of 2.24 seconds ahead of everybody else.
Is it two touches?
Oh, hang on. We may have some touches. I can hear.
That will be massive for this team.
One touch on the 90 degree. That time doesn't become as comfortable.
So
it keeps them in first place, but it now becomes a 50.73. That's 50.73 seconds. They've reduced their lead by 1 second there, and I think they're going to be catchable by these other teams.
Yeah, I mean, they were going so quick, I didn't even see that touch, did you, Tom?
No. No, it's because it's an orange blur of a team. They knock an orange ball off, I don't even notice.
I mean, they're great to watch. I hope they can do that again for us and try and do a clean run and get a good time down and be out there with the big boys.
I wouldn't be surprised with that team if we hear pretty soon that it's a retirement, that they pulled from the racing, because, you know, Little Indy, she gives everything she's got, but for such a big course, horse welfare comes first, and they might not want to run again. However, I'm not with the team, and I don't know how much energy they've saved by pulling every other one.
Who knows, yeah.
But now we're with the team of Just Drag. These guys are an advanced team, soon looking to be elite. They are every bit elite as everyone else out there, and they have won every single heat this weekend so far. So the rider is Emily Gray, and the boarder is Sean, as they hit the first corner, 22 miles an hour.
Yeah, it's going to be really nice to see this team stretch out a bit, and already showing they've got a bit of pace about them. Start really sort of growing into the sport, this team, just gradually getting experience, being on the quiet, sneaking up behind into the elites, hopefully, in the future. And you can see the difference between, even though they're advanced, they've sort of really got their sort of flow down in their team, really. The communication's there, the rider's often checking on Sean, the boarder, who looks very comfortable at this speed. So it'll be interesting to see when they add a bit more speed on top.
Yeah, their split time was just a couple of seconds faster than Send It Siblings. 22 miles an hour into the last turn. Sean getting wide, starting to have to work quite a bit around John Bowers Bend and onto the Bruco Marketing corner as they cross the line. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the advanced team of Just Drag with a time of 59.27 seconds. And that puts them into first place in the advanced class.
Yeah, very good run from them. Not a surprise. I think you can see the progress now on that team, and looking to push on now as well. You can feel that they've got it between the teeth, and they want to fight the big boys.
So I do want to give like a big shout out to Alert Training, who are the paramedics on site this weekend. They've looked after a couple of our boarders from yesterday and made sure that we stay safe in the arena, and you'll see them watching horseboarding. And I've even heard they've started using some of the footage from horseboarding crashes as training for when they come to these events.
Why?
Well, everyone's been all right.
Touch wood.
Okay, here we go. Jill Winston, this is the team that are looking to push on this weekend. They've already won the first two heats in the first day, came third in the second earlier this morning, so they've got a point to prove. Already a good start. 27 miles per hour into that corner, that's very quick. You saw Aiden just take off in that corner as they're getting faster and faster. Oh, that's great boarding, really good sitting in behind Winston as they go across the diagonal.
Yeah, into the red back boots, double bend. I didn't even get a chance to say the name as they hit the chicane. Aiden getting low, having to readjust side to side. Now they're aiming at the 90 degree time. This is going to be a quick split time as they hit the split at 30 seconds dead. Oh. It's a massive couple of touches there, but I don't think that's going to matter. Ladies and gentlemen, this team is going for first place even with some touches as Aiden rides the outside. It's a great bit of work. Can hold on? Yes, he can. Ladies and gentlemen, the team of Jill Winston with a time of 47.65 seconds. How many touches did they get?
Is it one touch?
We're just waiting for confirmation. I saw two cones go, which meant two balls, but I don't know how the referee judges that obstacle. It might be just one touch.
Yeah, one touch. Roger that, one touch.
It counts as one touch, that their time becomes a 48.65 seconds. They leap into first place.
Wow.
And now there is
a touch.
2.08 seconds separating first and second place.
I mean that passed the eye test, didn't it? That looked like a fast, we're going for first place here, all out on their first run. So, I mean, that's a really good run from them. And even though they got the touch, I think it's a really, really good time. It's going to set the pace, I think, for these other teams.
Yeah, and remember, you know, if your first run time wins the heat, you get a bonus point. So right now, Jill Winston are looking at 11 points if they win this heat, and no one else can beat their time. But coming into the arena now is a team of Just Wing It. They came second in this morning's heat, but what they're going to do first here, they're going to do what I think is more of a schooling run. They're not going to push on. They're going to wait and build over the three as they hit the first corner at 24 miles an hour. It's still a proactive run, but it's going to be a steady, fast run.
Yeah, it looks like a really good pace, actually. Sort of lots of control, but still gathering across the ground very quickly. So Sandy's not being too troubled at the moment. And it's looking very smooth as they go into the chicane. Ooh, a tight line there for Sandy, having to turn quickly, but seems like he's got control of that. It's all very good at the moment, and the pace is on a split time of 34.35. Ooh. Very wide line for Sandy.
That's a good bit of boarding from Sandy, just riding that. I wonder what's going to happen to him when they go faster and he comes through that line. But ladies and gentlemen, round John Bowers Bend, it is the team of Just Wing It as they cross the finish line with a time of 52.34 seconds. That's their foundation, Ross. They're just figuring out how fast they can go around this course. We saw them do that in two runs this morning and then nail the last run.
Yeah, some teams are dropping their foundation in run and just going for it, and that team sort of did a bit of both, didn't they, really? It was quite a very competitive speed, but you can tell they were still holding back slightly, just waiting to see what other teams do, and probably just to get a feel, as you say. I think it's a lot quicker out there today than this morning. So 27 miles per hour we've been seeing to this corner, Tom, isn't it?
Yeah, well, talking about 27 miles an hour, the team coming into the arena now, it is the team of Blues and Twos. We've seen this pairing, Amy Richards and Ryan Roberts. They were on Top and Tails, but this is their second team, Blues and Twos. They want the bonus point. They are in second place in the championship, and they want to take all the points they can, and they're now going to go and try and beat Jill Winston with this run. So here they go, the horses, Sally and this is the team of blues and twos as they head down the opening straight into corner one. It's 27 miles an hour again. Ooh. They're matching Chill Winston into this first turn as they come around. Wow. Bruco marketing corner. Ryan Roberts sticking on the outside. Amy taking a wide line there on the horse as they come into the red back boots double bend. Ryan gets low, looking down towards the chicane, and it's a tight turn from them. Great work from the horse riders.
Yeah, Ryan having to do a lot of work there, correcting it all the time. Big pull on them down the line there. Ryan going straight on his face. He's correcting his movements all the time as he goes around the corner. A split milliseconds in between each bit, and he's working it. He's holding on for dear life, Tom.
This could be close now as they come up. 44 seconds on the clock. How are they going to take first place? It's a time of 47.59 seconds. Is it a clear round?
Clear
round. Blues and twos jump into first place and steal that bonus point off Chill Winston. And they are back into first place. They're in first place by 1.06 seconds. Whew, that was a bit of a heart-wrenching first round, wasn't it, Ross?
Yeah, I mean, already the team showing what they want to do and where they're coming from. That is, I mean, that was an amazing run there from that team, Blues and Twos. They've been doing that all season, sort of fighting out with Chill Winston. And so they sort of know that pressure on those top races, but they're bringing it a lot sooner than
I would
have thought.
This team, if they win this round with a bonus point, and Chill Winston comes second, they will win the weekend by 1 point.
Wow.
If they win the event without the bonus point with 10 points and Chill Winston in second, it's tied. So Chill Winston are going to come back out fighting for it. But let's not talk about them. Let's talk about the team of Dead Pigeon. Caden Bemis, Charlie Buss, 27 again, miles an hour into corner one. What are these teams doing? Aiden riding the outside.
Aiden getting some really big pulls there, his other hand flying up in the air as he tries to balance and take the full force down the line, using two hands into the double gate there. So much work, so much pressure on that board going up into his legs, having to pull up round these corners. Oh, great flow from Miranda Boom, though, slightly running out of pace on some of these corners, Tom, but split of 33 seconds.
It's still a good pace as they come round. Remember, Aranji Boom has not done a lot of competitions, and Charlie Buss flinging it into that corner. Aiden's still riding the outside, his Elvis arm up in the air, trying to counterbalance everything that he's doing into Bruco marketing corner, and it's through the line with a time of 50.35 seconds. That puts them into third place. They knocked top and tails down one position, and they are now only 1.7 seconds behind second. Top and Tails have retired from the rest of the racing. We thought that would happen, so they can't do any more. They're now in fourth place. It's up to everybody else to see if they can beat that time.
Okay, yeah, I think that's probably the best they could have done. Third place for Dead Pigeons. That's interesting, because so Chill Winston and Blues and Twos fighting it at the top, as we said earlier on. And I mean, Dead Pigeon and Top and Tails having a good little fight, and Just Wing It can come from nowhere. So it's already all to play for. This team in the arena now, Send It Siblings in the red, the youngsters, and they've already been showing us straight away that they've progressed so much over all the comps that I've seen them, for sure. And this has been a really challenging course, 90 miles per hour into that corner, which is, again, really good, Tom, for this team.
Yeah, it's good for them. They are 8.07 seconds behind first place Just Drag, but that team looking to go into the elite on a much bigger X-Racing horse, and the team are actual adults. You know, Finella is 15, Josh is 18, brother and sister combination, and they're working really well together. As they go into the red back boots double bend onto the chicane, that's a great line that time from Josh. Still getting a bit of a pull, but his boarding style and where he needs to be placing himself is getting better and better.
Yeah, as I said before, he generally boards with one hand and all the way, but it's obviously using two. Oh, he just sat down as I said that. And,
great release.
Oh, looks like his legs might be going, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a long weekend for him, but he's done really well. They all have, really, in Send It Siblings. So put your hands together. Well done, guys.
Are you all good, Josh? I think he's all right. It's only his bum and his pride that are hurting at the moment.
Yeah, that'll be definitely a pride on that one. Well, sometimes your legs just give out in the corner, and that's the difference. You've got the fight left, or maybe you don't, and... I mean, it's such a tough course for some of these borders. So long way round, isn't it, Tom?
Yeah, definitely. But we move back on to our other advanced team. This is absolutely fabulous. Their first weekend ever racing at competition. They did earn themselves a yellow card in the last heat for an extended, the last round for an extended period of trot. That's where, you know, the horse drops out of the canter. Within the rules, it deems that the horse is doing something you're not asking it to do, because you're asking for the canter, and then that just comes under that, and it's a yellow card. But these guys doing extremely well for their first weekend competing. We just like to see them get a complete run at a canter, and I think, do you know what? They can hold their head up to high this weekend and be like, we've done it. We've started.
Yeah, 40 miles per hour to that kind of, I mean, if you're looking to get into this sport, this is a really good team to watch, because they're just starting, taking on all these distractions, obviously the flags, the cones, all you guys, all you lovely people, and they're sort of keeping calm, keeping the horse calm, just making sure it learns its job, and obviously sort of the border learning and the whole communication between the team, and that's all they need to do is you need to get out there and do it. And that's what this team are doing. So you've got to take your hats off to that. They're doing very well this weekend.
Yeah, through the chicane, they're starting to work that line a bit better. The board rider actually following the horse this time and, you know, working on the lines. This is where they had problem last time. And it looks like they're just withdrawing. They've released. I don't know if that was a mechanical error with the stuff. Or maybe, do you know what? This is a big course for a pony. Maybe the pony's had enough for the weekend. But I think big pat, big pony love, and then these guys have done extremely well. So ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to get involved in horseboarding and you think, do you know what, this is something that I could do, then just go to our website, horseboardinguk.org, or come and have a chat with us at our trade stand. It's right next to the commentary box, two big flags above it, and you could be on the other side of the fence competing with these guys. And if you're wondering why there is a little blue tractor at one end of the arena, that's because John Bounds spent until 8:30 last night rolling and mowing this arena with us so these teams could compete today. And if you're wondering what that little thing is, it's a Solis 26 HST cab, and it goes for the fetching price of £13,795 plus VAT, and it could be yours for just that pocket change. Right, now we're back with the advanced class, and it is just drag. It's Emily Gray on the pony, it is Sean on the board, and these guys are soon to be an elite team.
Yeah, I'll see what they'll do. They're starting very slowly, so I imagine they've already sort of won enough this weekend. They're sort of getting bored of it, Tom, aren't they? They're just going around again, actually. That's what's happening.
She can't take it off.
No.
I think that is a tactical withdrawal. They want to see if Send It Siblings will actually go out and push, because Send It Siblings have the pace. It's just about Josh's legs. If his legs can last a fast-paced run, they could jump up. 8 seconds is within that team. But you've got to remember, Send It Siblings are still learning. Josh, you know, I don't think next season, I think we'll see this guy come back ripped and ready to board. He'll hit the gym all winter. He's told me.
Yeah, I mean, he's got better and better than that they have as a team. So it's going to be really good to see them progress. And I mean, there's a little battle going on between those two teams, but obviously Just Drag looking a little bit more ahead in their journey. And have been putting on the pace already this weekend. Anyway, so here are Chill Winston into the arena. They are looking to get basically what's between them and Blues and Twos, Tom?
1.06 seconds. And they have that because they had a 1 second penalty on their last run. All they've got to do is match what they did without the touches. 27 miles an hour into corner one as they go around John Bounds Bend into the Bruco Marketing corner. And Aidan Beamish getting that Elvis hand flying around trying to keep balance. They come across the arena onto the Redback Boots. Double gate.
Yeah, this looks very quick indeed for this course. Oh, look at that quick turn from Winston. Dived into that corner of the chicane there. Oh, Aiden's all out of shape. He's lost it. He's managed to let go at the right time before he got pulled on his face. So that was a good save there from Aiden. You can see how he got out of shape there, and it almost cost him heavily, but...
That was nearly a massive,
massive crash.
Ladies and gentlemen, the team of Chill Winston pushing the limits and finding the edge.
Oh,
and
he
Aiden,
did so well there.
Oh, like, that. The skill to not get a total wipe out there is absolutely phenomenal. I'd have been in the crowd barrier.
It's very tempting to back yourself in that situation. Just hold on a little bit too long. And that can really cost you in the way of the size of the injury that you can get. But
so they're going to be feeling the pressure now. This, you know, Chill Winston, they need to be in first place. They absolutely need to be in first place. One more run, Ross, they've got. But this is the team of Just Wing It. They could literally throw the cat among the pigeons if they wanted to. And they look like they're warming up for a more of a hot lap as they start. They are.
Yeah, this is really fast. You can see Annette smiling before they started.
30 miles an hour
into that corner. Annette punches the air. They know it already. That's something special on this course. Let's see, can they keep it together? Sandy going right down on his face around that corner. Not much.
Now they've got to bring it back, Ross. It's got to get tricky through the chicane. Horse darts in. Sandy making that tight turn. Flicking back onto the other side. They've done that clean. How are they on the split?
Big pull there from Sandy. He's got it back. He's all over the place, but he's managing to hold on, absolutely fighting out the back there, Tom.
22 miles an hour into this top turn. They could possibly do it as they come through John Bowne's bend onto the marketing corner. I don't even know what to say as they cross the line with a 49.31 seconds.
Perfect.
It puts them into third place.
Wow, ooh. What a run.
Wow.
Annette's loving that punch in the air. She did when she went past 30 miles per hour this top corner. Great to see them pushing the limits there. I mean, that on this surface, Tom, that is quite crazy.
Yeah, I mean, this arena, it's still a big arena with the tighter course we've got. The ground obviously holding up for them, but Sandy having to do some great work to stay on the board. I'm scared to see what they do next. Like, it made me want to close my eyes, and I'm inside the commentary box.
It was rather scary. It was indeed. And here's another team coming into the arena now.
I reckon
twos that can be scary to watch indeed.
We're going to see a tactical withdrawal here, Ross. We're not going to see a race.
Oh.
They're in first place. They have the bonus point. They are currently going to win the weekend with that bonus point. If they don't have that bonus point, they match with Chill Winston. It comes down to fastest time. Are they willing to take that risk? That's the question. No, they're not.
No,
tactical
they're not.
Withdrawal. So, ladies and gentlemen, a team has to cross the start line. If they don't cross the start line on their second race, they are deemed to have retired from the racing in this heat. So all that is using the rules in their favour so they can save the pony, they can
watch
Chill Winston have to do, because Chill Winston have to beat them.
Yeah, some of these teams, I suppose, looking to save their energy. It's been a really long weekend for some of these guys, patching up all their bruises backstage, but they're looking to hopefully just do one last
hang on, I've just heard, I've just seen.
No, it's alright.
Oh, no, I was getting false information.
Okay, so we've got three rounds immediately.
Okay, so Just Drag have retired from their last run. They think they've done enough. The ball is in Send It Siblings' court. Just send it, Finella. Just go for it. Don't worry about Josh. He'll
come
be all right.
Come on, siblings. Come on.
8 seconds. That's all you need. Just let the pony run. Let's see what they're going to do. They're going to start out, and Finella doing everything she can, not listening to me and looking after her border as they go into the corner. 20 miles an hour. That's the fastest we've seen them do. And Josh having to work pretty hard. I can already see from here that his legs are pretty much jelly.
Yeah, poor Josh is going to have to hold on, but they're looking a lot faster already, a little bit more pace, which is good. Again, Racing so maturely for their age, it's sort of just keeping the control. And Fresnella's obviously still looking after Josh as well, checking on him regularly as they come out of the corners, waiting for him to shout go, and generally looking after him, I think.
This is where he got it wrong last time, as they come onto the 90 degree. He sits deep. Can he hold it? Yes, he does. That is a great bit of work from him. He found where he failed last time and he's worked his way through it. As they come onto the last bend, all he's got to do now is just hold on as they go round John Bowne's bend up to Bruco Marketing Corner. This is the team of Send It Siblings. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause as they cross the finish line with a time of 63.95 seconds. They've done an improvement of nearly 5 seconds there, Ross. I think that deserves a round of applause in itself.
Yeah, you can see that was a good run when they started. Beat their fastest speed into this corner, and that just carried on from there, really. Not too many problems on that, and really smooth. I love the way Fresnella takes off the pace anytime Josh has a problem.
Can we have the elite back?
Great communication with that team, looking better and better every time I see them.
Okay, two runs left. Chill Winston and Blues and Twos. Chill Winston need to take first place off Blues and Twos to win the heat. Then Blues and Twos will have a chance to retaliate. It's all or nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you that are left around the arena, make your voices heard, because this team are going to put everything they can on the track. It is Chill Winston. They're an 8-time national championship team. Into turn one, it's 27, 29 miles an hour. Aidan Beamish holding on for dear life as he goes around John Bowes Bend onto Bruco Marketing Corner. Whoa. It's a wide turn. He hits the rough stuff, but he keeps hold of it.
So much speed there. Another big hit from Aidan straight, taking that wobble right into his chest. This is so quick to even talk about. The chicane's not even there. They're just coming straight. Oh, he's gone!
And release.
Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the team of Chill Winston, pushing the limits and finding the edge.
Oh, I'm so gutted for them. That looked so quick. That was unbelievable. Maybe just too quick around that top corner, just couldn't quite hold on. I didn't quite see what happened, Tom.
Blues and Twos retired last race.
And that, we hear Blues and Twos have retired from their last race. They know they have done enough to take the gold away this weekend with a £1,000 prize fund up for grabs. They are going to be taking the lion's share with them. So ladies and gentlemen, as our teams come out leading the way, they've won the weekend. It is Amy Richards, it's Sally, and they are the team of Blues and Twos. In the red, it is Fresnella, and that is the team of Send It Siblings. So shall we get through the results?
So what on the advanced teams we have in third place, absolutely fabulous.
In second place in the advanced class is Send It Siblings.
And Just Drag win the advanced, so well done to them.
And then in the elite class, this weekend, you haven't seen Spare Parts race, but they are in 6th place.
Top and Tails in 5th place in the orange.
In 4th place, it's Dead Pigeon.
Okay, yeah, and in 3rd place, Just Wing It with a great run at the end there.
In 2nd place, it is Chill Winston.
And Blues and Twos winning it for everybody. They've just had such a great weekend, Tom, haven't they?
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. You've been an amazing crowd. And these guys have been our riders of Horseboarding UK. Sorry, I didn't see her until
she came. Where was she?
So that's it from us here. That is the penultimate heat for round 6 at Cheshire. We'll be in Alresford next weekend. Then the weekend after that, we'll be in Sandringham for the 2023 final. If you want to get involved...